Understand that the dead will try to mirror the living because they want your life force energy. This is how they operate, just like zombies, just like vampires. They are the walking dead. So use the pain to push you forward into ascension, because understand that you have no business being in the third dimension. What you will find in the third dimension is abuse, chaos, trauma, and drama. And that is the vibrational state that pathological narcissists are stuck at. And they also want you to be stuck with them. Because misery loves company. And understand that as the living, you should not be communing with the dead. You bury the dead. You let go of the dead, because when you let go, you can ascend. And I do not care if the dead is an intimate partner, could be a parental figure, could be a friend, could be a boss, could be a co-worker, etc. Do not commune with the dead. Otherwise, you will see where you will also start to die, because you're picking up their vibration, you're lowering your vibration, you're lowering your standards. Get the courage to walk away and stay away. You have no business being in the third dimension. And ascension again is forgiving yourself. Forgiveness is letting go of negative emotions in order to ascend. So understand that it is of the utmost importance that you master your energy. It is of the utmost importance that you let go of these toxic individuals, because again, peace is on the other side of abuse. Abuse is negative, abuse is not love. Pathological narcissists are incapable of love, they don't even love themselves, they don't exist. They did not love themselves, that is why they abandoned their true self for a false self. And that is also what they want you to do. This is why it feels like you're losing yourself in these entanglements, because you are losing yourself. This is because you're communing with the dead. You should be communing with the living, other people that are on a similar vibration as you. So what we're talking about here is the fourth dimension or higher, people that are working on themselves, headed to enlightenment, headed to self-actualization, people that want their third eyes open, people that are raising their vibration. The only thing that pathological narcissists will do is drain you off your life force, because they are parasites. Parasites exist. Understand who the parasites are and avoid them. Do not let them attach to you. Let this be a learning lesson, and understand that pathological narcissists don't make sense because they are the walking dead. You were taught, like most of us were taught, that the dead were people that are in caskets, or the bodies that are in caskets. Understand that a lot of the people that are walking around here are dead. Earth is 85% dark. However, understand that this just means that you have to adjust your sails. They're empathetic, kind people. Light workers, star seeds, chosen ones out there, looking for people that are exactly like you. Those are the people that you should be communing with. They are your equals, people that have been working on their self, that have been working on their connection to spirit, not people that have been working on their false self and been working on manipulation. You do not want a pathological narcissist in your life because they are parasites. Don't coddle parasites. Don't nurture parasites. Cut off their supply, and you will see where they run off to find another supply, because that is what parasites do.